morning, class. My name is Miss Kennedy. Today our lesson is called Converting Base 5 to Base 10. So we're going to do some definitions right now and make sure to write them in your notebook. So base 10. This is the base number we use in everyday life to count things. It has 10 digits. From 0 to 9. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then this is a different basis than base 5. This one only has 5 digits, from 0 to 4. So it would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it has a notation that looks like this. The little 5 is called the subscript, and it tells us what base we are using. We are only using base 5 today because base 10 does not have a subscript. So the next one is base raised to a power. We aren't familiar with this symbol yet, but we're going to use it. It is called a power or an exponent, and it works like this. So 5 squared. We can see that 5 is the big number, which is the base, and 2 is the small number, which is the power. So it would be like 5 to the 3rd power equals 5 times 5 times 5. So here's how we are gonna solve this. You write down the big number, and then you put multiplication signs in between it. So you keep doing this until the big number is written 5 times. So multiply 5 times 5 times 5, which equals 125. So a conversion table for a base 5 to a base 10, which is this. So we're going to be using this table to do our calculations. So the first row is the base raised to a power, which in this case is base 5, which I've already filled in. The second row is the place value for each column. The third row are the digits that you're going from the problem you're solving. And the fourth row is the calculations of the place value for each digit, or row 2 times row 3. Next, we're going to go over the math steps that will tell you how to do each problem step by step while I work some examples for you. Then I'm going to hand out a worksheet for you to do on your own. So raise your hand if you have any questions along the way, or if you have any questions now. None? Okay. So I have a poster here. And the rules are, number 1, write powers on each of the 5s, numbering them backwards, like you're starting from the right-hand sign with 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, and so on. Number 2, calculate the value of each power, or the exponent, as we learned, and write it underneath in row 2. Number 3, Write down the digits from the problem underneath. In row 3, use the right-hand box as the ones place. Number 4, multiply the numbers in row 2 and row 3 by the column and write them in the box underneath in row 4. Number 5, add the numbers in the bottom row. And number 6, write the answer in the answer space, which our answer space is going to be right here. Okay, I'm gonna put this poster right here so we can remember it and see the rules. So we're going to work some problems now. So we're going to convert a number I'm about to write down, which is, let me erase this first so I have room. (1,231)/5. So, our first thing on the poster says write powers on each of the fives, numbering them backwards. So what we would do is we would write 5 to the 3rd, 5 to the 2nd, 5 to the 1st, and 5 to the 0 power. So number 2, calculate the value of each power or the exponent, write it underneath in row 2. So 5 to the 0 is 1, 5 to 1 is 5, 5 to the 2nd power is 25, and as we learned earlier, 5 to the 3rd is 125. So, our third rule was write down the digits from the problem underneath in row 3 and use the right-hand box as the ones place. So now we write in the digits from the problem, or the big number. So you would write in 1, 2, 3, and 1. So step number 4 says multiply the numbers in row 2 and row 3 by column and write them in the box underneath in row 4. So we multiply the numbers, which 125 times 1, 125, 25 times 2 is 50, 5 times 3 is 15, and 1 times 1 is 1. So, step 5, add up the numbers in the bottom row. So it would be 125 plus 50 plus 15 plus 1 equals 191. And we would put our answer in the box. And next, what we would do is we could also write 1,231. The base 5 equals 191. Okay. So here's another example. Erase it. Now we'll do our problem will be 2,013 to the 5th power equals, and then we're gonna find that out. So remember, number one, we write in the powers, which I've already done. So it's 5 to the 3rd, 5 to the 2nd, 5 to the 1st, and 5 to the 0 power. So multiply it, remember, 125, 25, 5, and 1. And then our number, the digits, are a 2, a 0, a 1, and a 3, which if we multiply them, it would be 250. Whoa, that is not a good 0. Try that again. 250. And then 25 times 0 is 0. And then 5 times 1 is 5. And 1 times 3 is going to be 3. So you add it. You go 250 plus 0 plus 5 plus 3 equals 258. So we can come back over here, right? 2013 to the 5th power is 258. So let's do one more example. We'll do 1,342 to the base 5 equals, so we've already written in our powers, and our place value again is 125, 25, 5, and 1. Then our numbers are 1, 3, 4, and 2, which means if we add them together, it's 125, 75, 20, and 2. So you add them together and you go 125 plus 75 plus 20 plus 2 equals 222. So you would come over here and put your answer as 222, or 1,342 to the 5th power to base 5 is 222. So are there any questions so far? Okay. Now we're going to work on some practice problems. So get into your groups and work on this for about 15 minutes while I walk around and check your work. I need 2 volunteers to help me pass out these worksheets. They have 3 tables and the math steps on them. Okay. You and you. Okay. Okay, 15 minutes has passed, so let's go over the problems. So our first problem can tell me what the first problem was. Yes, that's right. Our first problem was 1,342 and 4 to the 5th power equals blank. So our powers are already on our chart, and we're going to again do 5 to the 3rd is 125, 5 to the 2nd is 25, 5 to the 1st power is 5, and 5 to the 0 power is 1. So our digits are 1, 0, 0, and 4. So we multiply them again, and that would be 125. 25 times 0 is 0. Remember, anything multiplied by 0 equals 0. This would be 0 again. Then this would be 4. So before if I add them together, 125 plus 0 plus 0 plus 4, who can give me the answer? Yes. That's right. The answer is 129. So we would come over here and put 1004 base 5 equals 129. So our second problem. Our second problem is 2144 to the 5th power equals what? So again, we put our place value 5 to the 3rd, the 125, 5 to the 2nd is 25, 5 to the 1st power is 5, and 5 to the 0 power is 1. Then our digits are 2, 1, 4, and 4. So that would be 250 and 25, 20, and 4. So we add them together, 250 plus 25 plus 20 plus 4 equals what? Yes, that's right, 299. That is correct. So 2144 base 5 is 299. And our third problem. Who can read out the third problem for me? That is right. Our third problem is 3043 base 5 equals what? So again, 5 to the 3rd is 125, 5 to the 2nd is 25, 5, and 1. So our digits are 3, 0, 4, and 3. So 125 times 3 is 375. 25 times 0, remember, would be 0, because any number multiplied by 0 is 0. This would be 20, and then 3. So do 375 plus 0 plus 20 plus 3 equals what? Yes, that's right. 398. So 3043 to the base 5 is 398. So now that we've done it, are there any other questions? No? Okay. So this is how we do base 5 and base 10 and how we convert them. Okay, I'll see you next class. Thank you.